वेलकम। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ स्टैटिक टाइमिंग एनालिसिस। सो व्हाट आई हैव टेकन इज आई हैव टेकन अ डी फ्लिप फ्लॉप। सो डी इज द इनपुट, दिस क्लॉक इज द क्लॉक इनपुट, दिस क्यू इज द आउटपुट ऑफ दिस फ्लिप फ्लॉप, दिस इज द क्लॉक पल्स। सो आई हैव टेकन इट टू बी अ पॉजिटिव एज ट्रिगर्ड डी फ्लिप फ्लॉप। So in the positive edge trigger D flip flop, the output will change when the positive edge of the clock has arrived. So these are the positive edges of the clock. Let this be time T1. Let this be time T1. So at T1, first clock edge arrives. So the D input before time T1 just changed from 0 to 1. So on the arrival of this clock edge, this Q is the output. So it will also change from 0 to 1 on this clock edge. So this continues. Then just before the arrival of this clock pulse, let's name this as T3, this as T4. So just before the arrival of the clock pulse at time T4, this D input changed from 1 to 0. So after the arrival of clock pulse at time T4, this Q changed from 1 to 0. So this is a normal operation. But consider at time T5, the considered time instant T5. Now at T5, clock positive edge has arrived, but at the same instant T5, this D flip flop, this D input has also changed. You can see at T5, D is going from 0 to 1. So this is the problem, because now the output we cannot say for certainty what will be the output. We cannot say for certainty what will be the output, because both clock and D input are changing at same time. The clock is also going from 0 to 1 and D input is also going from 0 to 1 at the same time. So when clock and input both change or both go through a transition at the same time, we cannot determine what will be the output. Output will be 0 or output will be 1. At present output is 0 here. So we cannot say for certainty whether output will change from 0 to 1 or remain at 0. So this is called as condition of meta stability. So output is in the condition of meta stability. Output is not stable. We cannot say what will be the output at time T5. So this gives rise to two important time constraints. One is the setup time. Another is the hold time. These are the two timing constraints on the device. So constraint, we have to follow these two time constraints to get a perfect result or a perfect output. So the definition of setup time, setup time is defined as the minimum amount of time before the arrival of clock edge, so that the data must be stable for it to be latched correctly. Okay, so let's go to figure number 3. So this clock is at arriving at T equal to 0. Let this be T equal to T2 and T equal to T1. So this is T1, this is 0, this is T2. So the setup time condition says that the D input should not change in this duration from T1 to 0. The D input should not change in this in this time interval from T1 to 0 for it to be latched correctly. So you can see I have shown here the shaded portion. So in this time range, the D input can change. As you can see, I have drawn both 0 and 1. So D input can be anything in this. But from T1 to 0, in this duration, this is the amount, this is the time before the clock edge has arrived. The clock edge has arrived at T equal to 0. So this is the amount of time before the arrival of clock edge. This is the amount of time before the arrival of clock edge. So this is called as the setup time. So it is the minimum amount of time before the clock active edge that the data must be stable for it to be latched correctly. So if the D input changes in this window, then output will be in meta stable. But if D does not change in this window, then output will be stable. Then another condition is called hold time constraint. So as you can see, the clock edge has arrived at T equal to 0. Again, this is the non-shaded portion. So again, after the arrival of clock edge also, this D input should not change. This D input should not change between this time duration as well, from T equal to 0 to T equal to T2. So this is called as the hold time. So hold time is the minimum amount of time after the arrival of clock edge. Setup time was before the arrival of the clock edge. Hold time is after the arrival of the clock edge. So it is the minimum amount of time after the arrival of clock edge for which our input or our data D must remain stable. So these two, setup time and hold time, are the two time constraints which must be followed. So if the data changes in this region, then we can say there is a time violation. Time violation. So if the data changes during the stable region, then they are said to be timing violation. So in this region, from here to here, the data must remain stable. The data or the D input must remain stable in this region. Either it should remain 0 or it should remain 1. It should not fluctuate. If the data changes in this non-shaded region, before the arrival of the active edge of the clock, if the data changes in this region, then this time is called setup time. So if the data changes in this region, then it is called as setup violation. It is called as setup violation. If the data changes from T1 to 0, and if your D input changes between 0 to T2, then it is said to be hold violation. So the data must remain constant in this non-shaded region. The data must remain constant in this non-shaded region. So again, if the data changes in this non-shaded region, then we cannot say with 100% guarantee or with 100% confirmation what will be the state of the output. So that is called as meta stability. So this is the hold time and setup time violation. This is called the setup violation and hold violation, and this total phenomenon is called as time violation. So the data must remain stable during this time, from here to here. Thank you. Please like and share the video and subscribe the channel.